Is the key to our design. We seek to make products that are not only ecological but also emotionally durable.
We love to explore natural materials and reinterpret them in a new and exciting way.
Hi, I'm Essi.
And I'm Rasa.
Together we are Studio Blond Bieber.
And today we're going to show you how to do your own natural dye prints from microalgae.
So people often ask us why it's so beneficial to work with algae. For us, it's a great resource because it's 100% natural and non-toxic. That's our fabric, and we're going to roll it out and cut the size that we need. Like this.
What we need now is a textile glue to actually fix the textile to the table. Growing algae, you don't really need a lot, you just need a vessel, a little bit of sunlight that comes in, and some water, and then they grow by themselves. And the only thing that you have to make sure is that you let some CO2 come in, and that you also stir it every once in a while, so to make sure that the water circulates. And then the next step would be the filtering.
For the filtering, we are using this piece of fabric. This is actually an old screen fabric, and it's very fine, so the water goes through, but the tiny microalgae cells are staying in the fabric.
We didn't invent this technique. We got inspired by Kenya. And in Africa and Kenya, at Lake Chad, people are also growing microalgae. So they have big cotton cloth and they filter the water through the cotton, and later on they have this dried pigment left over.
We filtered some pigment that we can use for making a printing paste. It's important to understand that within Europe, algae are still considered as weeds. But on the other hand, there are great potentials that this resource has. The natural color palette of algae is made up of different species, so we actually get really nice and very different color tones. Maybe the most surprising color of algae is red, because that's a color that you don't associate with. We really like this color. It's surprising and it has a really nice effect over time, also changing into more of a pale, maybe a little bit yellowish red. And this is the color or the pigment that we're using today for printing.
This color is actually quite strong, so we recommend to use some gloves and maybe also an apron. And we're gonna mix this pigment with a printing paper.
So this is our pattern for the screen print. It's actually a dot pattern and a kind of landscape, a dynamic landscape that reminds of the microalgae cells in the water that are floating around. There are numerous other printing techniques like potato stamping or linoleum printing and then stamping. So once you have the printing paste ready, you can use various techniques with your hand and different levels of complexity to actually create your textile.
So the printing paste is ready now, and we have this really nice red color, And you have to make sure that it's really homogeneous, so no little dots inside, it has to be one paste. And we're gonna apply it to the screen now. Imagine, for example, you have a piece of furniture that you don't really like anymore because it's old. How about reupholstering it with a new textile that you made yourself with your own hands and that has a story that you actually like about it and that makes you connect to it in a different way? For upholstering, you need three different layers. So you need something like a very cheap MDF plate that has the shape of the furniture that you want to build. Then you need some foam. This foam is like a 5 cm foam that you use underneath. And then you have some fleece that comes over everything. And the textile is the last layer. So what we're gonna do first is cut our foam into the size that we need.
The next step after cutting the foam is the fleece, which will be added on top. Our mission is to implement the small imperfections of nature and craft into our design. So in the end, we are creating objects and products that tell their own story and have their own identity and personality in a way.
The textile industry definitely needs to change. And as consumers, we have this in our own hands. We can create objects that are actually personal and that live longer than the intended life cycle of the industry. As designers, we want to create objects that people want to keep for a lifetime.